Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Previously, I discussed or I showed you on how to configure the 4645 voicemail in Alcatel OmniPCX Enterprise or OXE system. And today, I am going to show you on how to enable the voicemail in an extension number. Let's take a quick look on this extension number here. This is extension 1000. Or 1000, and to check if the voicemail is enabled on this one or not, you can go to the mail icon here and click the voicemail.
The number dialed is not authorized.
And as you can see, it says the number dialed is not authorized, which means that the voicemail is not activated or enabled on this extension number. So let's log into the system and enable that one. Let's open that one and log in to our system, and you need to identify the voicemail number. So to do that, I think I showed you that in the previous video about 4645 configuration. So to check what is the voicemail number, type the command vmail all, and from there you can see that the voicemail number, let's expand this one. The voicemail number is 1099 and it has a number of access of 8. And I think I also discussed this to you about what is this 8 access means. And by the way, if you haven't watched that video, click this link here, or I will put the video link in the description below so that you can watch it and understand or learn on how to configure the 4645 voicemail in the OXE system. Okay, so now let's enable the voicemail of the extension 1000. To do that, go to the MGR tool, type MGR, and go to the users, then review modify. Since we know already the extension number, we can go to the directory number and type 1000 and control V and go down to the voicemail directory number. It should be in here, voicemail directory number, this one. And all you have to do is type the voicemail number, which is 1099, and control V, and control V on the second page. And as you can see, it says command succeed. And if you look at on the user's desk phone, in our case this one here, the extension 1000, the mail icon is now blinking, which means that there's something on this one. So all you have to do is just click, and as you can see, the reason this icon will blink is if there's an answered call, there's a callback, or there's a new voice message. In this case, it has one new voice message. Click that one.
Mailbox 1000. Please enter the password and press hash when you have finished.
The default password for the voicemail when you activate that one is 0000 or 4 zeros.
You have reached your personal voicemail box. You will be asked to enter your personal settings. Please enter the new password. The password must contain at least 4 digits.
And then it will ask for a new password. I can put in there 1122 for time being. It doesn't accept 1234.
Your new password is 1122. To confirm, press hash. To change part, modification accepted. Please record the name now and press hash when you have finished.
Ozzysero.
To confirm, press hash. To review your recording, press 1. To erase and re-record, press 5. To exit,
so
press star.
Ozzysero.
To confirm, press recording accepted. You have no new messages. To send a message, press 2. More option. To leave a message, press goodbye.
Okay, that's it. So the voicemail is now set up on the desk phone as well. As mentioned earlier, the new password, it doesn't accept the series number like 1234 or 2468. Alright, so that is up now. So to access a voicemail, you just go in here and go to your voicemail.
Ozzysero.
Please enter the password and press hash when you have finished.
Put in the password 1122 that we put in.
You have no new messages. And to send a message, press 2. More options, press.
I don't have messages at the moment because no one left a message yet. And so basically that is how to enable or activate a voicemail in an extension number. Now let's have a quick look on how to manage the voicemail, such as changing the password and also if you want to clear the voice messages. So let's do that. So let's cancel this one by pressing Ctrl C. We need to go back to the prompt, and from there it will be using the EVA tool, capital EVA underscore tool. Press enter. From here, as you can see, you have lots of options here. You can modify a password, delete messages, or delete all messages from mailbox. Okay, let's try the modify a password number 2, and then enter the mailbox number 1000. Please enter the new password. Let's say 2233. Our old password is 1122. Now we're changing it to 2233. Enter. And as you can see, the mail icon is blinking again. Let's open that one.
Ozzysero.
Please enter the password and press hash when you have finished.
Okay, so let's put in the 1122. If that will still work.
I'm sorry, that is not the correct password. As please you can see, try again and press hash when you have
it's
finished.
It's now incorrect. So let's put in the new password that we just put in, 2233.
Please enter the new password. The password must contain at least 4 digits.
To create a new password, 4455.
Your new password is 4455. To confirm, modification accepted. You have no.
Okay, so basically in the EVA tool, once you change the password, once the user is logged onto the desk phone, it will ask for a new password. Okay guys, so let's do some testing here. I have another extension number here, which is 1001, and I already set up the voicemail for this one, so we can do some testing. One thing to take note, guys, when the system is first set up, by default there is no forwarding to voicemail. So when you call this number and no answer or no reply, it doesn't go anywhere. If I call the extension 1001, it will just keep ringing because the system is not set to automatically forward to a voicemail with no answer or the extension is busy. However, you can do this one manually in the device itself or in the desk phone itself. Let's do that now. So as you can see, this an unanswered call. I can delete that. So what you can do is, once you have the voicemail enabled, when you go to forwarding, this icon here, you can have this immediate forward to VM. Okay, so let's click
your
that one.
Has been recorded. You may now hang up.
And this one now is forwarded to the voicemail. So if I will ring that one, 1001.
You have reached the mailbox 1001. Please leave your message after the tone and press hash when you have finished.
This is a test. Testing. And testing.
To confirm, press 1. To review your recording, press to send your message with normal delivery, press 1. To send your message sent, to exit, press star. To leave a message.
Alright, so as you can see, the mail icon is now blinking. It means there is already a voicemail received on this extension. Let's open that.
Mailbox 1001. Please enter the password and press hash. You have 1 new messages. To review new messages, press 1. To review all messages, press 1. To first new message.
This is a test. Testing.
As you can see, the voicemail went to the 1001. All right, so that's how to set up the voicemail. Okay guys, I will give you a quick bonus tip on how to enable the forwarding when no reply or no answer or the phone line is busy. Okay, so let's remove this forwarding first. Deactivate. So as you can see, there's no forwarding, and obviously if I will call that number, that will just keep ringing, doesn't go anywhere. Like I mentioned before, it's not set up to forward to any number. Alright, so let's do that. To do that, we need to check first in the users and check the phone features that the extension number is using. Let's go to review modify and let's check the all instances, and these are all our extension. Let's go check the 1000, and as you can see, it is using the phone feature cost 0, and that's a default. If you look at the 1001, it's also cost 0, and 1002 phone feature cost 0, 1003 phone feature cost 0. So what we will do is we will modify the 0 phone features so that it will forward to the voicemail automatically when no answer or the phone is busy. So let's go to the class of service to do that, and phone features COS review modify. We know that it's the 0, so we'll just select the 0, Control V, and go to the bottom, and you should be able to see this voicemail forwarding. By default it says ring final set mail. Let's leave it that way. There is an option there, but ring final set mail, which means it is set to the final number as the voicemail number as well. So let's click this one, default overflow type. At the moment it says no forward, so we'll go forward on BC and no answer. So it means that default overflow type, when it's BC or no answer, it will forward, it will overflow. And default overflow address, we will select and choose associated, but the one we're looking at is the voicemail, and that's it. Just Control V to save it, and the database is now updated, so we'll give this a try. What is this clean? Oh, the unanswered. Okay, delete this one, and now let's give it a try. So if I will dial 1001, let's see if there is no answer, it will go to the voicemail. So there is a certain timer in this one, guys. It's not covered in this discussion, but we can modify.
You have reached the mailbox 1001. Please leave your message after the tone and press hash when you.
There you go. So that's forwarded to the voicemail. And also, if this is busy, so let's say you want to dial. So let's make the phone busy now and dial 1001.
The called extension is busy. You have reached the mailbox 1000.
It's working, so it goes to the voicemail as well. Alright, so that's about it, guys. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. And thank you for watching.